So I want to talk about how to increase the diversity of your gut microbiome or friendly bacteria. Now, why would you want to do that? Because the more diversified your microbes are, the more benefit you're going to have with insulin resistance, weight loss, reducing inflammation, reducing allergies, strengthening your immune system, and increasing the bioavailability of nutrients. So what are all the things that will increase the diversity of your friendly bacteria? Number one, feed them fiber, as in vegetable fibers. Number two, having different types of vegetable fibers. So if you're eating just the same vegetable over and over and over, you're not going to near have the diversity that you should have. So you want to rotate your vegetables. You want to have salad with a lot of different things. That will help you. Also, people that are not overweight, if you lose weight, you'll have more diversity in your gut versus someone that's overweight is going to have less diversity of microbes. Fasting, very, very powerful action to increase the diversity. Apparently, when you don't eat, your microbes get stronger, they live longer, and they develop in diverse ways. Also, polyphenols. Okay, this is a phytonutrient that are in a lot of different foods, nuts and seeds and vegetables and berries. So a wide variety of things. But even like chocolate and coffee. And of course, I'm not recommending chocolate with sugar, but there are a lot of different things that have polyphenol, including wine. So this is your time to start drinking to increase your diversity of bacteria. And I'm being very sarcastic. The problem with wine is the alcohol part, and I'm not recommending that as an option. All right, fermentation. Consuming fermented vegetables like sauerkraut is very, very good. Now, check this out. Here are the things that will decrease the diversity of bacteria in your gut. Snacking, eating too frequently. If you overfeed your microbes, you get less diversity. All right, sugar will decrease diversity. Antibiotics, of course, allowing the bad bacteria to grow, because one of the things that the good bacteria does is they actually take up the space in the food, so the bad bacteria cannot live. There are many, many bad side effects that occur when you take antibiotics. One is weight gain. Alcohol will decrease the diversity. GMO foods, and I'm talking about the main herbicide in GMO foods, which is glyphosate. That apparently blocks microbes from producing amino acids and neurotransmitters. All right, next one, artificial sweeteners will also inhibit the diversity of your microbes. So if you don't have enough microbes, that can also affect insulin resistance, and that can actually affect your blood sugars. So here you are, not knowing this, you start doing sugar-free this, sugar-free that, using the traditional artificial sweeteners like aspartame, and you're gaining weight, and you're wondering why. Okay, being overweight, we mentioned that. Frequent eating, we mentioned that. And of course, stress. If you haven't seen my other videos on the microbiome, I put them up right here. Check them out.